In today's episode, I will show you how to use the Noise and Deform tool in Element 3D. Let us create a new solid layer and name it Background. Now we will add the gradient ramp. In the Layer Settings window, I will change the ramp shape to Radio Ramp. And I will position this point in the center of the screen. I want to make the background a dark purple color, so I will make the changes to these two colors. Let me make this a little bit lighter. The center color looks a bit too noticeable. I will change the position of the second color. This looks good. Okay, I will lock this layer and now create another solid layer to add the Element 3D effect. I will name this layer E3D. Leave the rest of the settings the same and select Accept. Now let's go to the Effects menu and add the Element 3D effect. Now, let's select the Scene Setup button. Inside Element 3D, I will create a sphere. The sphere will appear on the left side of the screen. We can also see that the sphere is inside Group 1. I want to change the color of the sphere to a red color. Let us select the texture layer, and under the basic settings, change the diffuse color. I will select the red color and then press accept. The sphere is now red. I now want to add an environment light. Let us go to the preset tab and go to the environment folder. I will select this one. Immediately, you can see the light source has been added to the scene. I want to increase the reflectivity. I will change the intensity to 50. Perfect. I will also change the reflective color to red. So this is looking good, but I want to make sure there are enough segments to do all the deformations. If we change this to wireframe, we can see that there aren't enough segments. Right here, you can see that we only have 2160 vertices. To increase the segments, I will select the sphere model and go down to the segments row and change it to 30. You will immediately see the new segments that have been added. We can also see the vertices count be at 54,000. Now let's go to the surface options. Anytime you add any deform or bending or twisting to a model, we want to make sure it's set to dynamic deform. We can also multiply the number of polygons on an object by increasing the subdivision level. This also helps when using the deform options and you want a smoother edge. I will change it to 2. You will see the vertices of the sphere jump to 324,000. Depending on your computer, this could cause it to slow down in performance. For a quick fix, I could check the optimized mesh box. You can see the vertices count reduced. I have a good workstation, so my computer will handle it with no problem. However, I would advise you to adjust your settings accordingly to what your computer can handle. Let's change the sphere view to shaded. I am happy with how this looks now. I will select the accept button. This looks great. Now let us deform the sphere. Let us drop down the Group 1 menu. Make sure it's enabled. Under Particle Look, go to the Deform menu. Make sure the Enable box is checked. Go to the Noise menu and enable that box. I will adjust the intensity. You can see how it affects the sphere on the left side of the screen. I will set it to be 100. You can see what the scale does to the sphere. For the scale, I will set it to be 150. Evolution creates an endless loop animation. But we will get back to this later. For now, I will go to the Advanced menu, and we are going to change the Y intensity to 500, and the scale to be 250. Let me change the Y intensity to be 548. Now, I will enable the twist settings. I will focus on the twist y-axis. Let me change the value to 90. This is looking good. And I will change the color tint to be purple color. I am now going to play around with the physical environment light. By checking on this box, you will see what the environment light looks like. By rotating the y-axis, you can see how the background light affects the 3D model. I'm going to have the value be at 207, and then uncheck the box. On second thought, let me change the value to 199, and the light tint to be a bright purple color. I will increase the exposure and decrease the gamma by a little bit. Okay. Now I will enable the ambient occlusion and select the quality to medium. I will change the intensity to 10. And the contrast to 1. This all looks great. I will now create a camera to maneuver around the model. I will make sure it's at 35mm and then press accept. Now that I have my camera, the model, and the lighting set up, I will do a little bit of animation. I will make sure the marker is at the ending of the timeline. And then add a keyframe to the twist y-axis, the intensity, and scale. I will come back for the evolution later. To display the keyframes I just made, press the letter U on your keyboard. The controls we see on the right side of the window will now appear in the timeline beneath the Element 3D layer. This makes it easier for me to navigate when animating. Having dragged the marker to the beginning of the timeline, I will change the value to 0. I will press the play button to see the preview. This looks good. However, I want the animation to finish sooner, so I will position the keyframes here. And now, I will animate the evolution. I will drag the marker to the beginning of the timeline and add a keyframe. You see the control did not appear in the timeline. To do that, you will need to press U twice on your keyboard. Now you will see the evolution control in the timeline. I will change this to 0 and then move the marker to the end of the timeline and add a value of 3 here. I want to also animate the size of the model. For that, let us go particle size, add a keyframe, press the U on the keyboard twice, position the marker to the beginning of the timeline and make it 0. Perfect! I will now smooth out the animation. I will do right mouse click and then go to keyframe assistant. Then select Easy Ease Out. And for these keyframes, I will do the same, except I will select Easy Ease In. And there we go. You have now learned how to use the Noise and Deform tool in Element 3D. You can also animate the cameras to get some cool looking effects, like this one. However, that will be for another tutorial. If you found this tutorial helpful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Till the next one!